This video we are going to see the overview of Azure portal. Okay, for going to the Azure portal, first of all open any of your browser and search for portal.azure.com. portal.azure.com. Okay, once you click this, you can able to see the Azure portal like this. Okay, we will see what are the options available in Azure portal. Okay, if you see here, I have activated my Microsoft Leon Sandbox. Okay, if you don't know how to activate this, you can able to see my last video. I will provide the link in the description. Okay, okay guys, this is the Azure portal like looks like. In the first of all, we can see what are the services we have recently used and what are the resources we have used. Okay, this is the instance to create a resources and this is the resources we have already created. Like I already created like Yago storage like that. You can see okay what are the services we have created here. Okay, likewise, a few of the options like we have mostly used like subscription. Okay, all resources dashboard. Okay, and also you can see useful tools like cost management, whatever it is. And we can able to see the useful links to manage Azure. Okay, in Azure portal we can have multiple options to create resources. Okay, we can see one by one. Okay, okay, in this we can see create a resources and we can able to see all services and we can also able to create services using this global search box. Okay, we will see one by one then what is the difference. Okay, if you go to all the services, okay, you can able to see all the services in Azure. Okay, you can see all the services. Okay, I already told in Azure we have more than 600 plus services. We can able to see all the services here. Okay, they also categorize the resources based on the category. Okay, if you see here, if I click compute, the service related to compute, it will be displayed here. Okay, if you see virtual machine, app services, okay, availability set, all came under compute services. If you click networking, we can able to see the load balancer, network watcher, public IP address, resources related to networking. Okay, like that we can able to see all the services. If you click DevOps, we can able to see DevOps related services. Okay, and the one thing, if you want to see all the services, we simply click all and we can able to search all the services. Okay, like virtual machine, you can able to see virtual machine. Okay, you can able to see. Okay, if you go to the networking and we cannot able to search for virtual machine. Okay, okay, only in that particular networking service we can able to search for particular all services. You can search click for all. Okay, and then you can see the favorite services. Okay, this favorite service we can able to see in the this tab. Okay, under the favorites we can able to see all the favorite services and also we can able to see our favorite services. Okay, once you go to availability set and if you want to add this as favorite, simply click this star. Okay, once you click this star, we can able to see the virtual machine scale set is added to the favorite. Okay, we can able to also see the virtual machine scale set added in the last. Okay, if you know that, you simply remove this star. Okay, like this we can create all the Azure services using all services. Okay, all services. Okay, and another one thing, if you see here all resources, okay, once you click this, we can able to see what are the services we have created. Okay, only I have created, only as of now I have created only two services. If you created multiple services, we can able to see all the services here. Okay, and we can see create a resources. Okay, create a resources, then what is the difference between all the services, okay, and create a resources. Okay, in this also we can able to see the resources and categories based on the category. Okay, if you click compute, we can able to see the compute related services, but only the difference is in the all the services we can able to see only the Azure related services. Okay, okay, but if you want to need to create some other third party tools, okay, then we can go for create a resources. Here Azure also integrated with multiple third party vendors. Okay, here we can see their services also. If you see, if I search for virtual machine, okay, not only the Microsoft virtual machine, we can also able to see the third provider vendors virtual machines also. Okay, whatever the resources we based on the requirement, we can able to create here. Okay, then this is the difference between all services and create a resources. Okay, then we have also option to create a resources. Once you came into any of the page, if you go to the homepage, you can simply click Microsoft Azure. Okay, once you click this, we can able to go to into the homepage. Okay, we can also have option to create resources using this global search box. Okay, once you click this global search box, we can able to see multiple options. Okay, what are the search history we can recently what we type here, we can able to see here, and what are the recent services, what are the recent services we have recently used. Okay, if recently I have clicked the public IP address load balancer, okay, we can able to see here, and what and we can also able to see what are the resources we have created. Okay, this is created resources and this is the instance of the services. Okay, we can able to create directly, go and create here. Okay, and here we can able to create resources. Simply search virtual machine, we can able to see Azure services. Okay, and here we can able to see third party resources. Okay, and also some useful documents to refer the virtual machine, and also we can able to see categories. Okay, if you click all, we can able to see all the things. Okay, if you click services, only Azure related services we can see. If you see marketplace, only the third party vendors resources we can able to see. Like documentation related to the virtual machine, we can also find multiple documents here. Okay, I not have resources in virtual machine like resource group, so it not showing. Okay, once I have, we can able to see here. For see all the things we can able to see here. Okay, okay, and not only this, we can able to see in the global, we can also use this global search for how to create like that. We can able to find all the things, useful things here. Okay, simply type for how to create a storage account. Okay, simply I said I also found the Azure services as well as I have found the useful links. Using this, we can able to create a storage account. Use this thing, we can refer how to create the storage account. Okay, yeah, and this is the three options we can able to create a resources. Okay, this is this and this create resources, both are same option. Okay, This is the graphical user interface. We can manage all the services using graphically. And in the Azure portal, we have another one option. We can able to manage the Azure portal through comments. Okay, for comments to be accurate, we have to click this cloud circle. Once you click this, it asks we can able to use Bash or PowerShell. Okay, if you are came from the Linux background, then it is better to use Bash. Okay, CLI commands. Okay, if you came from the Windows background, we can able to use the PowerShell. Okay, both are useful to manage the Azure services through comments. Okay, this is the option we can able to use. This is a new tab. Okay. And also we can find the notification. Okay, once whatever the resources you have created or deleted or updated, we can all the things we can see here. Okay, recently I have created one storage account called Yahoo Storage. It's showing deployment success. Yes, it is created successfully. We can able to manage all the things. Okay, which it is created 11 minutes ago. Okay, like this. If you go to the settings, we can also manage the directory. Okay, as of now I have two directory, default directory and Microsoft Lens Sandbox. Okay, in this default directory I have no premium account, so I not able to create resources here. Once you switch here, we can go to the default directory. Okay, like that. If you click this appearance, we can able to manage the portal appearance. Okay, if I click this white thing and if you click update, we can if our portal theme is changed to white. Okay, like that. We can able to see the okay. If we can also able to change the home screen. Okay, now it is in default home screen. If you want to change into dashboard, we can able to change. Okay, it is like a home screen. Okay, if you click apply and if you go to the home screen, if you click directly here. Okay, now you can able to see our home screen is changed. Okay, here we can able to add what are the resources we need. Okay, simply we can add and manage. Okay, it is like a our home screen wallpaper. Okay, in this we only keep our recently used app like that. We can able to we can use here. Okay, for edit the dashboard you simply click edit and we can able to manage the dashboard. Okay, if I want to keep the resource group here, we simply drag and drop. Okay, and we can also change the dashboard size whatever it is. We can also able to add the time clock time. Okay, once you satisfied, then you simply save. Okay, then we will be come to the home screen. Okay, you can see our home screen is came. Okay, like that we can able to manage the Azure dashboard. Okay, as of now I better with this home screen. Okay, so I am doing this. Okay, and also we can able to see the flyout on dark. Okay, and I will show you once. Okay, the flyout is nothing but once you click this three point trigger, you can able to see this option. Okay, so it is now it is in flyout mode. If I click dark, then it will be in the dark mode. Okay, if you see here. Okay, still it's not changed. I'm going to appearance. Okay, dark and apply. Okay, you can see now there is this tab is darker state. Okay, if I normally it simply click this. Okay, but if you click the flyout, it will be disappear. Once we click this three button, then only it will be appear. Okay, like that we can able to manage the Azure portal. Here we can manage the language. What are the language you prefer? You can able to choose your language, like your mail ID, whatever the things you can hear your information. Okay, this is signing and sign out. Whenever you inactive for 15 minutes, if you specify this option, it will automatically log out. Okay, like that we can able to manage. Okay, in this option we can able to see the service health. Okay, if you click this, we can able to see the all the services state. Okay, health services. If there is any services not working, we can able to see here. Okay, and also we can able to contact Microsoft support team by using this. Okay, whenever you need the help of the Microsoft team. Okay, like that we can able to do here. Okay, once you click this, we can able to give the feedback to the Microsoft. Okay, here this is the account details. Here once you click this, you can able to see the username, your mail ID, and you can able to switch directly. We already see, and we can also use different account. We can able to use here. Yeah guys, and that is about the Azure portal overview. In the coming section we will see one by one. Yeah guys, thank you.